Hello guys, Skyline Park is the next one to talk about, and I decided to make this a top 10 ride because they have so many rides. It's a really interesting park because they have all the rides that used to be on a kermis and travel around, but then not anymore. Then they got to Skyline Park, and the park is located in a field, and that's clear to feel. So it's a weird location. And it's not the most pretty park or anything, but it's definitely not an ugly park as well. I thought it was going to be that, but it isn't. I made this a top 10 because we have so many rides, and you were probably wondering why some of them didn't make the top 5. And you were probably still wondering why some of these didn't make the top 10. I can tell you right now that the spinning coaster, the Mauritshuis spinning coaster, didn't make it. It is so rough. Not enjoyable at all. I hated it. It's one of the worst coasters that I've ever ridden. So that didn't make it. The suspended spinning coaster didn't make it. It's just boring. Yeah, not much to say about it. The Nordic Jets didn't make it, even though I loved the one at Tolk Schau. But this one is the older model, and you can feel they are outdated because they don't really give any airtime compared to the one in Tolk Schau. So let's just get right into the list with number 10, where I have High Fly. So I was really disappointed about this ride. I expected this to be top 3 rides of the park easily because it looks so great. And the thing is, it's powered. It doesn't go on gravity, which means you go so slow in the bottom. And the only good thing about this ride is that it has some hang time, but it's not even that good, the hang time. The restraints kind of kill it, so I'm just not a fan at all, really. But it still makes the top 10. Number 9, I have Sky Dragster. So this is the weirdest coaster that I've ever ridden, that's safe to say. And it's kind of fun, but it doesn't really do anything special to me. It doesn't have any forces whatsoever. A little bit of laterals, but yeah. It's just fun to look at. It's more fun to look at than it is to ride, to be honest. It's, yeah, not that good at all. So at number 8 spot, I have Vejle. So this is a traveling flume, and it's pretty fun. It's not one of the best flumes, but definitely not one of the worst flumes that I've ridden. Number 7, I have Geisterbahn. I believe this is new for this year. And it's definitely not good quality or anything, but I got some scares in there, and yeah, I just thought it was really, really fun. Not anything too special, but yeah, I think you should give it a go if you are at the park. At number 6 spot, I have sky rafting. So yes, another one of these water slide rapids like rides, and this one is the weakest of them, but it's still really, really fun. It's unique since it has a elevator lift instead of a normal lift hill. But the thing is, the boats spin too much on this one. It's not as aggressive. It's just some G-forces, which isn't that strong at all. So the weakest of those, but they are all so fun. Number 5, I have Nostalgische Achterbahn. So this is the Schwarzkopf Wildcat. And it's the best of the two wildcats that I've ridden. This one gives some decent floater airtime if you are in the back at least. I only rode it once in the back, and it's just so much fun. I love these classic Schwarzkopf rides. Number 4, I have Bob Racing. So this is really, really fun. It's like the one at Toverland called Maximum Blitzbahn. Yeah, it's a powered bobsled, powered Rodelbahn, if you can say it like that. It's so much fun, and this has a lot of tiny hills, and yeah, obviously they will not give you airtime, but they give they're just so much fun. It's hard to explain exactly why, but they are fun, and this is a really, really fun ride. For sure, top 4 and almost top 3, because number 3 is Skywheel, and it is a fun ride, however, it is a little bit underwhelming. The forces you get on the bottom is not that strong at all, So the only thing this ride really had to offer is hang time and laterals because the twist element at the top, the inversion, double inversion, yeah. The lift hill is so much fun because it's so steep at the end. I mean, it goes all the way to upside down, 180 degrees. So it's a fun ride, but it's not mind-blowing at all. However, it's smooth, and I didn't expect that because that I've ridden the Freischutz the day before, and that was rough as hell. This one is smooth, which I found as a big surprise. At the number two spot, we have Sky Circle. I've ridden two boosters, and this is way superior to the one in Disneylandia. It is much more intense, and the rotations works so much better. This is a really, really good ride. One of the best flat rides that I've ridden. Just a fantastic ride. No doubt that this is better than the Skywheel for me. But number one is by far Skyshot, the slingshot at the back. I love these kind of rides. The launch you get is insane. And the free feeling by just, yeah, you have no control up there, and it's so much fun. It's scary, but it is really, really, really fun. And I love these kind of rides. And this one is free. I mean, you don't have to pay extra, which you have to in most of these kind of different amusement park rides. But I like that this is free. That's awesome. That means it got a queue. There's 40 minutes while Skywheel was walk on. So that says something. But it's all worth it. Amazing ride. And be sure to ride it if you are at the park. Thank you for watching this top 10. I hope you enjoyed, and next one would be Svappenpark, I believe. Yeah, Svappenpark. Stay tuned for that. Bye, guys.